Hey guys, and welcome back. So in this lecture, I'm going to show you how to use virtual buttons in Vuforia. So if I click over here with my virtual button, the zombie will rotate. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, so let's go to step number one, which is open your old project. Okay, so the first step is to open up the scene in the last lecture. So in the previous lectures, we imported our AR camera as well as our targets. Now you can either use the dragon target or you can import these stones into Unity. In order to do that, go to Vuforia, develop, target manager, and you can add a target as we've done before. If you're not sure how to do it, you can check out my previous videos. So over here, I added my stones database and I downloaded the database and imported it into Unity. This is what you have before. So with dragon target selected, you can go to image target and select stones. And this will bring up your new marker. Next, the zombie that we imported in the previous videos, we're going to drag and drop onto our marker. Let's just place him around and rotate him a bit into place. And then we can make him bigger. I'm going to make him 1.2. Make your zombie a child of the dragon target. And then let's rename him zombie. Press play and let's see if it works. Just make sure your webcam is connected. Okay, as you can see, with our marker, our zombie is attached to our marker and it is working perfectly. If you're not sure how to do this, please check out my previous lectures. So step one was to download the target marker. Step two was to download the zombie. And now we go to step three, where we add a virtual button to our code. Go over to Vuforia, prefabs, go to virtual button and drag virtual button into our hierarchy. Now make sure virtual button is a child of the dragon target. Okay, so go to assets, scripts, and let's create a new script. We're going to create a C# script and call it VB script, otherwise known as virtual button script. Double click on the script and it will open up into Mono Develop. So the first thing you need to do is to import the Vuforia library into our script. And then we can instantiate the virtual button event handler. We're going to create a game object called VB button object. This is a private variable. So for now, we don't need void update, so we're going to delete that for now. In void start, we're going to look for our virtual button. And this button will rotate our zombie. Now select the string over here and let's rename our virtual button to do that. Rotate zombie button. And then we add the register event handler for virtual button behavior. So once we have it initialized, what we can do is we can create a function for onButtonPress and onButtonRelease. To find out whether or not it's working, we'll put a debug to console. So before we can run it, we have to place our button on the marker. Let's make it a little bit bigger. Now for this to work, the button has to be on the marker and not on the edge of the marker, otherwise it won't work. Okay, so before we finish off, let's just change this name to VB script and then save. Let's compile our code. Okay, so once you got that, drag your script onto your dragon target. You should see the script appearing over here. Now we can go ahead and see if our virtual button works. As you can see, our button says pressed and not pressed whenever we touch it. Okay, so we're almost there. Step 5 is to add a 3D object to our virtual button. So we can resize this to the size of a button. And now we're going to add a cube to overlay onto our virtual button. So right click, add a 3D object, and resize this to the size of the virtual button. We can make the cube a child of the virtual button. Next, we can add some 3D text to it. So right click, 3D object, 3D text. And then we're going to type rotate zombie, or just rotate. We can change the color as well, make it red. And then shrink it down to size to fit the button. Okay, let's take a look at how it looks. Now what we can do is we can edit our script and we can make it rotate the zombie. So go back to the previous script that we were working on. So now what we have to do is we have to create a game object for zombie. And then we assigned our game object to a variable called zombie. Now when we press our button, it must rotate the zombie. So let's go ahead and write code for that. We'll create a new vector. This code is similar to the one we've done in our rotate script. Make it a 3. Let's see what happens when we run our script. As you can see, our zombie is now rotating using a virtual button. Okay, so that is it for this lecture. I hope you enjoyed this course. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. And I'll see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.